But I think that getting Banjo into Smash Bros, what I was going to say is that that is literally a game seller. Like, yeah. If right now you told me there was new DLC for Smash 4 for the Wii U, and it included Banjo as a playable character,
we would not be playing Banjo-Kazooie right now.
I would turn this game off and download that immediately. Yeah. Like,
it's a lot like what Sonic was in Super Smash Bros. Brawl.
Exactly. And I mean, fucking Solid Snake.
And Snake as well.
Can we get another character like Solid Snake in our game, please?
I don't think Snake's ever going to go back because Konami's gone all weird.
Yeah, because...
But,
they'll replace Snake with a Pachinko Snake.
Pachinko Snake? I would see someone from, like, Advance Wars, like Sammy, for example.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Using, like, a variant on Snake's moveset.
That'd be pretty good.
I think that's, like, appropriate.
Yeah.
She's, like, infantry and, like, kind of, like, in the field, sort of, like...
Mm-hmm. No, I like where that thought is. I'm trying to think of somebody, like, similarly, like, a guest character from a different brand to Snake.
Who would be good in Smash Bros?
Yeah, who would fit in a Smash-style game. Because, I mean...
I think Cloud is probably, like... Super, like Smash 4's like version of Snake.
Oh, easy.
Where it's like the character that like no one thought could ever happen, and then it's just like, oh yeah, he's a thing.
And
like,
instead of having instead of being a sword fighter, but instead of having a down B that's a block or a parry, he's got a frickin' incredible limit breaker charge.
That is very cool.
God, it's so good. Yeah.
I think I'm pretty much done here. I've just got to do the golden crocodile and the tip top stuff, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's just about it. I'm trying to think right now.
The notes are in the tip top place. Is there this one only has one honeycomb, right?
I believe so. Oh, that's how you do it. the other obvious character from a Metal Gear side of things is Raiden, but
yeah.
Raiden's already in PlayStation All-Stars, which we all know is the better game.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah. It's just a fact.
I bought that game on launch.
How'd you do with that? How did that treat you?
Well, I mean, I bought it on launch.
Yeah, like, yeah, it's a true thing.
That's what I did. Main Sly Cooper.
Sly Cooper? Good character.
Because I really like the Sly games a lot.
Yeah.
Sly
Cooper's a good character, and his posse, the hippo and the turtle,
yeah,
good
Murray
characters.
And Murray and Bentley,
yep.
Respectively.
Good characters.
Got kind of sick of being shit on by, Kratos and Raiden and Nathan Drake.
Oh my god, Kratos was just designed to make people sad.
I don't know.
Oh,
like,
there was a skull. Do a 180, or sorry, right there.
There he is.
Yeah.
I'll just walk right off the edge.
That's fine. We're professionals.
That's how hype I am for that skull.
Please! Yeah.
Yeah, all seriousness, PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale is not a very great game.
No. I feel like there's something that I kind of get about it in a very sort of minuscule sort of like I understand the broad stroke of what they were trying to do. But
what they were
like,
trying to do was Smash Bros, but like with Sony characters.
Yeah, it's just like they took some fundamental things that work about Smash Bros as just like a game that plays like a video game.
Mm-hmm.
And we're like, ha! We don't need that. It's like the fact that you can only get a kill by using
your
super.
And like some characters, like their supers are just really, really good. And
like,
some characters are just not.
Kratos' super is a screen sweeper. You kill freaking everything. Big Daddy.
Big Daddy's is good, yeah.
You submerge everybody in water. They can't swim. You just walk over to them and punch them real good.
Whereas Sly gets like the Diddy Kong like jetpack with the little pistols thing.
Yeah, not great.
And it's just like not very good.
Yep. And Raiden gets something pretty good. I can't remember what his thing is. It's some sort of like Ike throw his sword up in the air and punch everybody's dicks. Nice. I was gonna say, I don't know if that's gonna hit, but
no, I knew. I always
beauty.
Knew.
Beauty.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I will say PlayStation All Stars does like the story mode better than Smash Bros. Like maybe not better than like the Subspace Emissary.
Subspace Emissary is the
which,
fucking
if you're gonna say
tits.
If you're gonna say a good thing about Brawl, which, you know, there's not a whole lot in my opinion to say there. Subspace Emissary is definitely one of the extreme positives.
Mm-hmm. It's it was a very good thing.
Yeah. They have like rival matches at the end of it, like characters like match up.
That's pretty cool. Kinda like Mortal Kombat story mode.
Or Soul Calibur.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. If you could take any single character out of Super Smash Brothers All-Star, or sorry, Super Smash Brothers
PlayStation
All-Stars. PlayStation All-Stars, bro. If you could take one character out of PlayStation All-Stars and put them into a Smash Bros. Game, any Smash Bros. Game, take your fucking pick. Which character would you bring
Which
over?
Character would I put into?
Yeah, which character you think is a good fit or would be fun to play under, like, clearly Smash Bros. Rule instead of Dirtbag?
I mean, in terms of characters that I want in Super Smash Bros., they have to fit the rules. Mm-hmm. That, like,
they have to make sense to the way that a Smash Bros.
Like,
game would play.
They have to, like, I mean, and by what, but, oh, that's a uncomfortable looking position for that.
Yeah, I think he's stuck.
Me too.
Oh, I think he's dead.
He's dead now.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it's the, there's a couple rules that they have to be in order to be eligible for Smash Bros., and this is something that, like, Sakurai, the developer of Smash Bros., has put down. They have to have originated in video games, so no Goku.
Oh yeah, fuck. Goku's never going to be in a Smash Bros.
Game.
Yeah,
that's never gonna happen.
I'll tell you that for free.
And then, like, they have to have appeared on a Nintendo console as well. And they have to bring something interesting to the table.
Okay.
So that makes it hard for me to pick a PlayStation All-Stars character.
Okay, well, sorry. Disregarding the contingency that they appeared on a Nintendo console. That's the one rule I'm gonna strike from the... Because
that is Sly Cooper.
It's like, easy. Yeah, that's a good pick.
Like, no, like, hands down. Just, he's my favorite Sony property. It's Sly Cooper.
Nice.
Right. I played Arkham Asylum around the same time I played Sly Cooper, and I felt more sneaky in Sly Cooper than I did in Arkham Asylum.
Man, Sly Cooper is a game for feeling sneaky. They nailed, like, head of nail hammered, effectively. There it is.
I knew it, too, and I want to get it, but now I'm talking to Tip-Tup.
God damn it, Tip-Tup.
I should also just point out that the giant turtle that we are now in is named Tank-Tup, which I enjoy.
Yes, very, very good. Also, he's hollow. He has no organs.
Yeah, he's a shell of a turtle, literally. Mm.
He got, like, a Dementor's kiss done to him at some point.
I didn't want to talk to you again.
All right. Purple, yellow, blue.
Dark blue. Specifically.
Well, blue instead of teal.
Sure.
Come on. I went to art school, Benjamin.
Nah, you got me.
We'll
count that one for you.
Chuck one up for the poor kid.
Especially after the snacker nipper debacle.
Oh, God. Shut up.
You're going to hear that one for a while.
Oh, I'm sure I am.
I think it's red, blue, yellow, blue, purple.
I actually was going out of my way to not pay attention, because if you screw it up, then I've got something to lord over you, and if you don't, then I'm very happy for you.
Well, you should start being happy then.
I'm very happy for you. I think that I would bring the Big Daddy.
Oh, yeah.
From PlayStation All-Stars. Because, first of all, BioShock is not a PlayStation property.
Nope.
I don't know why the Big Daddy was originally featured there.
This one's gonna get fucked up, guaranteed.
Ah, well. But the Big Daddy is super cool, and Smash Bros. Doesn't have a lot of tank characters.
Holy, I just took damage for that.
Yeah, if you fuck up, you get hit. Talk shit, get hit.
Yeah, I guess. I'm just gonna get rid of the limbo token back here.
Not bad.
I'll tell you what, though. If there was one Sony property that I want to get representation, it's not a Sony property. But, like, mm-hmm. it would be Persona 5. Okay, I think I got this.
Yeah, I think so.
It's this
yellow,
one.
Yellow, blue, red,
teal,
purple.
And then it was purple, and then
yellow. And then yellow, and then teal.
Yeah. Yeah, it'd be... I would, like, put Joker from Persona 5 in.
Okay. You'd go Persona 5 specifically, you wouldn't go for, like, one of the older Persona games?
I am woefully unfamiliar with the Persona games.
Oh.
But I did enjoy the hell out of Persona 5.
Okay, alright. Again,
and
a game that
also
I...
Also, it has the bonus of coming with the music.
Oh, that's very good. Because the music in that game
The music
is
in Persona 5 is awesome.
Boom, baby!
And now I just gotta get that,
That single... Tip-top! Stop talking to me! I, when I was very young, this is going to harken back, this is going to date me pretty significantly.
Well, I mean, Like, that's fine compared to me, because mm-hmm. I'm an old man compared to you.
Okay, Ben. But when I was young, I made a friend through a website called iSketch. Anybody? No?
No, not ringing any bells.
iSketch was essentially like, it was a lobby-based online chat game for essentially Pictionary.
Makes sense with a name like that.
Yeah.
I'm going to see if I can pick up some items.
Yeah, go for it. And I made a friend named Selena, who she was, you know, she's just a girl who lived in California, like a youngish Asian nerd, and I was a youngish Canadian nerd, so we just kind of got along. We just had, you know, we talked about video games and stuff like that, and we were friends on MSN after that.
Oh, I'm missing MSN.
I know, MSN. And then we had many conversations about, like, you know, video games that we liked and stuff like that. And she told me that her favorite game of all time was Persona 4. And I had never heard of this game before.
Yeah.
And so I was like, oh, wow, what is that? Like, I'm really interested. My favorite game of all time right now is, I think, 2007. Let me think really hard. I think I said it was Mario Sunshine.
That's a fair game to say.
Yeah, I'm still a fan of Mario Sunshine. Big fan.
Yeah.
But she told me about Persona 4 and how it was this really cool game where there's all the stuff that happened and all the symbolism and these cool characters with different demarcations and things like that, and they all play different roles, and you had this like social link quality thing to what was going on.
It's like a little bit life sim, but also it's a JRPG.
Yeah, I was like, man, that sounds awesome. I was also a big fan of Phantasy Star Online Episode 2 at that point, so...
I never played that. I almost bought that on the GameCube, which is a bit of trivia, like, the only game that uses the GameCube broadband adapter.
Yeah, it actually was. Nobody played that online, despite the fact that its name was online.
I'm pretty sure with the Dolphin emulator, you can...
Oh, yeah, no, there were servers, but you had to do a lot of workarounds. Yeah. But anyways, she was talking about that... And she sent me a trailer, like a YouTube link to a trailer, right? Mm-hmm. And what I saw, I found out probably maybe in the last like 3 years of my life, she sent me a trailer for Persona 4 Arena.
Oh, the fighting game. I've played that.
Yeah, which is, I get it. Don't believe me, but I have never felt more betrayed than when I found out that she said her favorite game of all time was Persona 4. And then years later, I found out that she sent me a trailer for Persona 4 Arena.
Yeah.
I was like, how many lies am I living at this point?
Tragic.
Yep.
That's just a tragic story.
I think I need to come back here as a... Oh, as the gator. Shit.
Yep. All
right, that's gonna be our last play here, Ben.
All right. It was a good run.
Yeah.
You know what's funny is if neither of us had obligations. Oh, my Fitbit is dying. If neither of us had obligations for the rest of the day, we could totally do this.
Oh my god, we could bang this game out in one go. Easy. But that's what two goes are for.
Yeah, I guess so.
Oh man. Alright, well, there's a thing that we do on the channel here, and it's kind of arbitrary at this point. I'm going to say arbitrary like 9 times in the next minute or so.
Okay.
But it's an arbitrary thing at this point because you and I both quite passionately enjoy Banjo-Kazooie.
Yes.
And what we do on the channel, whenever we sit down to record a game, even if it's something that we're going to sit down and record something more of later, which we clearly are going to at this
point. Yeah, I think that's a given.
Yeah. What we do is we rate the game on an arbitrary rating system. A rating system that we make up. Any sort of rating system, any amount of anything out of anything else. And because we're coming to the end of the first recording session here, Ben, I want you to rate Banjo-Kazooie on an arbitrary rating system that you made up.
I would give it 4 Mumbos out of 5 Jinjos.
Okay. I like it. Sticking to form. I'm going to give it a rating... I guess, let me think real hard about this, because it's going to be a hot second before I get my gator all the way out to that
frost-covered peak. You got some time, because the gator, not the fastest little dude.
No, he's not. He cannot talon trot that one. Come on, Banjo. Thank you.
Well, that's one thing I like about Banjo-Tooie that mm-hmm. I've heard. I haven't played Banjo-Tooie yet. Yeah. I've never even touched the game.
We'll get to that.
You start with all your stuff.
Yeah, oh yeah.
You start with the talon trot. You start with the moves.
Every single... There,
see? Whoa, look at you.
every single ability that you learned in the first game, you get to carry over. And then you just start learning new moves right off the bat. It's freaking wild. Like, one of the first moves that you unlock is you're speaking to Jam Jars, the military cousin of our dearly departed Bottles, and he teaches you how to use Kazooie as a gun.
Which I'm sure she is thrilled about.
She's like, and Banjo's like, well, and Jam Jars is like, kill her! Well, got a lot of information all of a sudden, all at once.
Excellent.
Jam Jars is so funny. He comes out of, like, proper, like, metal silos instead of out of dirt mounds.
Oh, that's funny.
And he, like the lid pops open and he jumps out and he goes, yeah. Burner, burner, burner now. Like,
he's got his own theme song?
Yeah, he's got his own, like, military-style theme song. It's very goofy.
It's very good.
And he always ended up back going, dismissed! And then jumping back into the hole. Yeah. And I think there's a certain percentage chance that at any given point, he'll jump up, and then the lid will close while he's in midair,
and he'll
bash his skull on the thing, and then, like, sadly hobble back into the hole, like drag his corpse back in.
Poor Jam Jars.
And it is absolutely hilarious.
You know, the saddest thing about doing this in two recording sessions is you lose all our lives.
Oh, man! Pour one out for each life, and by that I mean we're doing shots.
Are we? Like... It's like, I guess it's close enough to 5. Might as well.
Exactly. It's 5 o'clock somewhere, question mark?
I mean, it's 5 o'clock, like, one time zone over. It's 4:30 right now.
Aha! Yeah, we'll figure it out. Come on, little boy. There's something good down here.
There's gotta be something. Is it Cheeto?
I think it might be Cheeto.
It is Cheeto.
Yeah, look at that. Cheeto, the spell book. You found magic cheats I have for you.
I don't like the idea that she's just always watching.
Right? It kind of makes sense with capital B or whatever his name is.
Because you're in Book Worlds, right?
Well, because it's in Ivory Towers. He's clearly got security camera footage going on all,
like,
the time.
It's like a corporate location, and he's a corporate dude.
Blue eggs on Sandcastle Floor and Treasure Trove Cove World. Help you it will. Hidden in a lair, other spell books are. Them you should find. All right, so excellent. We got our first boy.
Like, he talks like Yoda.
Burr, burr, burr.
What is it? It's blue eggs, red feathers, and then golden feathers?
I think so, yeah.
I just remember the cheat code for co-op in the Adventure Mode, which is my favorite cheat code of all time, in Diddy Kong Racing.
Oh, yeah.
On the cheat code screen, if you put in joint venture, you can do the Adventure Mode co-op.
That is buck wild.
Yeah.
Man. All right, we're going to figure that out, because... Spoilers, we're going to figure that out anyways.
Yeah.
My arbitrary rating scale for Banjo-Kazooie is... one of my favorite games out of all time. Uh-huh.